Hey friends, Ash here with GentSense, and today we're going to be going over the top 10 men's fragrances that were released in 2018. Yeah. Now, how did I come to this, these top 10? Through Fragrantica, which I've done in the past. So what I did, as you can see right here, is I went to Fragrantica.com. I chose only men's fragrances that were released in 2018. Sorted them by popularity. So those top 10 right there. And I am taking those top 10 and I am ranking them according to where I think they should go. So essentially, I'm taking those fragrances, those top 10 released in 2018 specifically for men, and I am ranking them 10 through 1 in order of just my personal preference. How much I like them. And I'll give you reasoning why I'm placing them in the order that I am. We've got a lot to talk about, so let's jump into this and check out the top 10 men's releases 2018. Number 10 for me is an easy choice. Once I listed the fragrances out, took a look at them, it was just immediate. It jumped out to me and was like, yep, that one is number 10, easy choice. Zara Vibrant Leather. So this is not the first time Vibrant Leather was released, but it is listed as an official 2018 men's release, as a new release. So we gotta play by those rules. This is a re-release. Vibrant Leather already was done, the same fragrance, just a different bottle. And came out again. In case you're unaware, Vibrant Leather is an Aventus clone that Zara has done. And it's actually not the only Aventus clone that Zara has done. And Zara is really well known actually for taking fragrances and then discontinuing them and re-releasing the same fragrance, sometimes even underneath a different name. So it's kind of weird. Vibrant Leather existed, they discontinued it, they brought it back as Vibrant Leather, and it's the same fragrance, but sometimes they'll have a fragrance, discontinue it, release a new fragrance with a completely new name, and it's actually a fragrance that they had previously and discontinued. Yeah, it's confusing. This one only has three official listed notes: leather, bergamot, bamboo. Now, I know that doesn't really automatically draw Aventus comparisons when you're talking about note breakdowns. You're missing vanilla, you're missing pineapple, you're missing birch. But trust me, that's what this is. It's just an Aventus clone. And since it's just an Aventus clone, for me, it's an easy number 10 out of this top 10. Because really, does the world need more Aventus clones at this point? I don't think so. That's gonna take me to number 9. Number 9 was also very easy. This is one that immediately came to mind. After number 9, things start to get a lot closer, but 10 and 9 were easy for me. 9, Acqua di Gio Absolute by Giorgio Armani. C notes, woody notes, tonka, bergamot, some of the notes in the fragrance. To me, one of the worst Acqua di Gio flankers that's ever been done. I am not really a big fan. It's got kind of an Invictus type vibe to it, you know, a little bit of that bubblegum sweetness in there. Good fragrance for younger guys, potential compliment puller. Good amount of versatility in there for younger guys as well. Just for me, Acqua di Gio Absolute never really grabbed my attention. Absolute Instinct also was not a huge hit for me, flanker of a flanker there. But yeah, number 9, Acqua di Gio Absolute, pretty easy choice, not a big fan. Gonna take me to number 8, and like I said, this is where things started to get more difficult. A lot of these I kind of lumped all together. They were really, really close. So for example, number 8, number 7, number 6, all three of these, you could almost interchange them for me personally. There are things I like about some of these more than others. Really difficult for me to rank these out, but at number 8, Hermes, Terre d'Hermes, Intense Vetiver, or Oh Intense Vetiver, as it's officially known. This one, being a flanker, takes the Terre d'Hermes DNA and then switches it up a little bit, modernizes it some. You've got amberwood in the base of this fragrance, and one thing that's missing is the orange, which is really what Terre d'Hermes was well known for, one of the main things that it was well known for, along with some of the earlier flankers that came before this one. When Oh Intense Vetiver first dropped, most people were saying, oh, it's really not that great, you don't need to get it, just stick with the originals. And over time, people have started to like it a little bit more, a little bit more, a little bit more. It does have more wearability for a lot of people than the original, because it does dial back some of that earthiness or dirtiness from Terre d'Hermès Eau de Toilette and also the Parfum version that some people don't like. That being said, Eau Intense Vetiver is not one of those flankers, kind of like Absolue, that immediately grabbed my attention. I do think overall that it's a better fragrance than Absolue, and I think there's a pretty big gap between number 9 and number 8 for me personally. And like I said, you could kind of switch this out with number 7, number 6, and I wouldn't argue with you. But for me, number 8 is going to be Terre d'Hermès Eau Intense Vetiver. And that's going to lead us to number 7. It is Chanel Bleu de Chanel Parfum. It has lemon, sandalwood, cedar, and lavender, along with amberwood, which was in the last fragrance and also in some fragrances yet to come. Bleu de Chanel Parfum, to me, actually smells really nice. As far as blue fragrances go, one of the best smelling blue fragrances just on its own in a bubble. If all the other blue fragrances didn't exist, you would smell it and be like, oof, nice. There are some drawbacks that keep this from being ranked higher. First off, the price, $155 for a 100 ml size bottle. That puts it on the very high end of designer pricing. A lot of times designers will have prices that approach $100, even $120 at retail, but then you can still find them at discounters, so it helps cushion that blow a little bit. Good luck finding Chanel at a discount. You may be able to find one on eBay here or there that's not fake and get a few bucks knocked off, but you're probably gonna have to pay retail if you want it. That high sticker price, for me personally, knocks it down a little bit. And then their performance on Bleu de Chanel Parfum, for me, is the worst in the line. Eau de Toilette, Eau de Parfum, both have better performance. The fragrance itself, though, smells really nice. So while it's a great smelling fragrance, versatile, compliment pulling, all that, for me, in the year of blue fragrance flankers, which 2018 really was, this one comes in below its competitors. And number 6, we have Dior Sauvage Eau de Parfum. So yeah, another blue fragrance, and as I just mentioned, a competitor to Bleu de Chanel. Again, reiterating for like the fifth time, 8, 7, 6, these all kind of are lumped in together for me. Sauvage Eau de Parfum has Sichuan Pepper and Ambroxan, surprise of the century. If anybody has smelled Sauvage, they know that already, right? You've also got bergamot in there, vanilla, and lavender. So Sauvage Eau de Parfum is going to take the Sauvage Eau de Toilette DNA, and some people might say matures it a little bit, smooths it out, not as aggressive, not as in your face, not as loud, with that sometimes metallic smelling Ambroxan. The Ambroxan is still in the Eau de Parfum though, it's still very prevalent, but that nice vanilla really helps smooth things out and sweetens it up a bit. Sauvage Eau de Parfum, also very expensive at full retail, but you can find that one at discounters for a small discount, so you can find it sometimes under $100, which is better than $155, which is better than the $155 it's gonna cost you to get Bleu de Chanel Parfum, and the performance on Sauvage Eau de Parfum is better than Bleu de Chanel as well. All right, number 5, Paco Rabanne 1 Million Lucky. This one is a bit interesting. It's got notes like honey, plum, and hazelnut, but it's a fragrance that for me works best in springtime. It's also got ozonic notes and grapefruit in there, so it's not like it's all darker, heavier notes, but it's an interesting fragrance in the sense that it takes these notes that you would most often consider to be wintertime or falltime notes in a fragrance, richer, sweeter, maybe a little deeper, and uses them and a potential warm weather scent. It's also fairly unique. It's not a fragrance that's trying to copy something else out there, so it gets points for that. And it's also pretty versatile and compliment pulling. Performance is also good, so there's a lot to like with 1 Million Lucky. Now, 1 Million Lucky doesn't really smell similar to the original 1 Million. There's not a lot of that original 1 Million DNA in 1 Million Lucky. And that's something that's carried over into 1 Million Parfum, the newest release in the line. I got 1 Million Parfum just about a week ago. I'm not super keen on it as of yet, but 1 Million Lucky has grown on me over time, so it's possible 1 Million Parfum does that as well. So while 1 Million Parfum, not super keen on for 2020, in 2018, 1 Million Lucky, solid. And for me, there is a gap again between number 6 and number 5. 1 Million Lucky, I would clearly choose over any of the fragrances before it. Now we get into the top 4, almost in the top 3. Number 4 is going to be from Azzaro, and it is Wanted by Night. The original Azzaro Wanted was kind of a low-key hit with the fragrance community, or a lot of people in the fragrance community, because it gave you an Invictus style fragrance, but on the cheap, and a lot of people actually liked what Azara Wanted did with that DNA more than the original. Azara Wanted by Night, though, does its own thing. It's not another Invictus style fragrance. It has fruity notes, incense, cedar, it has orange, it actually has cumin in there, and cinnamon, along with, of course, the fall time fragrance note staple, tobacco. Wanted by Night basically is what it says. It's a fragrance made for nighttime wear, more specifically fall, winter, and maybe spring, as long as it's not too hot outside. This fragrance smells really nice. You can usually pick it up around $50-ish, sometimes less, at discounter, so it's not too expensive. And it's also a big compliment puller and smells like its own thing. So even though it is a flanker that is flanking a fragrance that smells similar to Invictus, this one does its own thing and does it well. And I've got to give it some extra points for that. Affordability, versatility, compliment factor, and uniqueness, Wanted by Night, pretty solid. Now we're in the top three for 2018. Number three is going to be one of my favorite blue fragrances, though it does catch a little bit of hate here and there in the community. Yves Saint Laurent Y Eau de Parfum. Part of the reason this catches a lot of hate is because it got talked about a lot when it came out. It is not the most hyper unique thing on earth, but does it absolutely crush it in terms of just mass appeal and versatility, more so than almost any fragrance that's come out in the past few years? Yeah, sure does. Apple sage, ginger, bergamot, and amberwood, some of the main notes in the fragrance. And when this one dropped and really took off, I feel like the usage of amberwood in men's designer fragrances almost tripled. It was getting used a decent amount before Y Eau de Parfum dropped, but Ambroxan was what everybody was talking about. Ambroxan, 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 Ambroxan. Then Y Eau de Parfum hit with amberwood, and then it changed. Amberwood, 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 amberwood. And that's still going on today. So a lot of people are not gonna like this because of that, and if that's the case, I understand. I'm not gonna hate on you for that. This one is just, as I said, enormously appealing. You can wear it in every situation. Date night, casual, formal, year round, it works. So you can hate on Yves Saint Laurent for this fragrance, but they were trying to make a fragrance that would appeal to everyone and sell tons of bottles, and that's what it did. And I actually really like it as a dumb reach kind of fragrance, because I know, as I just said, it works in every situation. So I can just grab it, spray it, and go. It's gonna work, and has good performance too. All right, top two. Number two, Gentleman Eau de Parfum by Givenchy. This one has Tolu Balsam, Black Pepper, Vanilla, and Orris, or Iris. And this one gets compared to the Valentino Uomo line and the Dior Homme line because of that Orris. So it's gonna give you a little bit of a creamy sweetness. Some people are gonna compare it to makeup. It's also got kind of a dark feel to it, which is not really a surprise when you look at the bottle, and it's all in black. This is one that I actually was able to smell at a store before I blind bought it, because I end up blind buying most of the stuff that I own, realistically. And I was blown away. I said, man, this smells awesome. Love it. And immediately went and bought it off the internet at a discount, which is what you should do too. Don't pay full retail. What are you doing? Save some money. Unless you can only buy full retail, and then I understand, I'm with you. I've had to do that too. Fantastic cool weather fragrance, fall time, winter time. For me, a little bit more of a nighttime type of scent, though I love it, so I'll wear it during the day. I'll wear it during the spring sometimes also. Summertime, not so much. I try to wear the fragrance as much as I can. Think that it's right there with the fragrance it gets compared to in terms of quality. Again, Valentino Uomo line, Dior Homme line, not all the fragrances in those lines, of course. And when this is actually available at discounters, because it does end up getting sold out fairly often, you can usually pick it up at a good price, cheaper than the fragrances it gets compared to. So that one's number two. That leaves only one fragrance, probably not a surprise if you follow this channel, Luna Rossa Black. Luna Rossa Black, pretty comfortably, pretty easily, was my favorite release of 2018 out of these 10. Tonka, Amber, Angelica, Patchouli. The fragrance is a little bit like if you took Bulgari Black, the little hockey puck looking fragrance, and Van Cleef & Arpels Midnight in Paris, which is now discontinued and goes for a pretty hefty sum. Mix those together and sprinkled in a little bit of Luna Rossa Sport over the top. That's a bit like Luna Rossa Black. The fragrance to me smells fantastic. It is unique. Now, I know I just said, you know, hey, take these three fragrances, mix them together, and you get this. So that makes it sound like I'm saying it's not unique, but trust me, to 99.9% of the people out there that aren't fragrance aficionados like yourself. I see you out there, very educated. Good going. It's gonna be unique. It's one of those fragrances that's kind of a surprising compliment getter. The first time you smell it, you might not go, oh yeah, this is gonna be a compliment beast. Like when you smell Sauvage or Y or Bleu de Chanel, you smell it and you go, oh yeah, super mass appeal. Luna Rosa Black, since it's a different type of fragrance, different style of fragrance, when you smell it the first time, you might be like, oof, I don't know if this is gonna work for me. There's a little bit of powder in here. You know, maybe it's a little bit too different than some of the blue fragrances out there and you might just write it off. But trust me, at least for myself anyway, it does really well. And I'm talking about compliments when I say that. Yeah. Like the fragrance that came before it, Gentleman Eau de Parfum. It's more of a nighttime fragrance, more of a fall time and wintertime fragrance as well. Though, as always, if you like it, you can wear it during the day. Nobody's going to arrest you for it. And with that, Luna Rosa Black, number one, that wraps this list up for top 10 fragrances of 2018. Ranked. Probably do this for 2019. Maybe we'll do it all the way back to 1975. Who knows? I'm playing for the most part. All right, guys. Going to do it for me. Thanks so much for hanging out with me today. Stay safe out there. See you tomorrow with another fragrance video. See you guys.